this. I mean, this is going to be key, isn't it, to the whole case you sense. I've got an extraordinary interview with some of Conrad Murray's previous patients coming up after this break, in which, you know, they portray him as almost a saintly figure, not motivated by money, very caring. I was quite taken aback by the strength of their feeling towards him. Is it fair to just label him as somebody who has been negligent and simply just allowed Michael Jackson to take far too many drugs and die?
Well, I don't think it's fair, and I think it's part of the conundrum that the prosecution has in this case. It's never easy to convict a doctor. Unlike journalists or lawyers, doctors are usually well thought of. So you, first of all, have got a doctor who was not out there, at least presumably, trying to harm Michael Jackson. I don't think that the defense took the position at all that the demonizing him, at least through the front door, there's kind of a roundabout way in terms of the argument that was made or the statements that were made today. But remember, this there's always a lot of trouble whenever you ask jurors to convict a doctor when he's doing something that's supposedly in the course and scope of his doctorly duties, if you will. And that's exactly what you have here. I mean, remember, Elvis's doctor walked when he was prosecuted. That was kind of the tack that that was taken with that case. I think that your previous guest, Joe Ellen, analyzed it that the kind of the reversal in this case is the key point. You've got the celebrity is not the defendant here. The celebrity is the person who died. And the defense wanted intelligent jurors, and they got some intelligent jurors. It's a circumstantial evidence case, and you want people who are a little bit smarter, who are not going to be taken away by their emotion, and who are going to analyze this case. And when they analyze it, they're going to come down to, did Dr. Murray cause the death? Is there a reasonable doubt as to that or not?